Good morning and welcome to George Preston Arena, where the Spartan women's hockey team is set to finally hit the ice in the first ever Spartans Hockey Skills Challenge in support of Shoot for the Cure. And without further ado, let's go down to ice level to Tyler Jones, who's with Spartans head coach Jean Laferre. Tyler, take it away.
We're here with head coach of the TWU women's hockey team, Jean Laferre. Jean, this has been a bit of a strange year. Could you tell us how you guys have stayed prepared for the return to play?
Well, I've got to give credit where credit is due, and that's to the girls, because we had some exhibition games early on in October, and due to obviously the COVID protocol, that slowed things down. They gave their all in the gym. They gave their all in terms of practice. We tried to keep things competitive as much as we could, given the protocols, but they were phenomenal in terms of keeping things going and allowing our program to continue to develop.
And what about today? We got a fun little event for us. Could you tell us what this is going to be like and maybe what should we expect here?
I think the girls are biting at the bit because it's the first time they've been together in a long, long time in a rink setting where there's competitive element and off we go. It's you know what, it's I think for us it's this is the culmination of our season. This is our championship for this year. And obviously when we close off our year, I think on a very, very positive note, the department's done a phenomenal job in providing this opportunity for the girls. So extremely happy, really, really glad that we can end off our year like this.
All right, we're all very excited. Thank you so much, Jean.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Jordan Tutu. I learned a lot about what it takes to be a team player from my days as a pro. Now I'd like you to join me and team up with Hockey Gives Blood to help save lives. Each year, hundreds of Canadians need a stem cell transplant to save their life. Anyone can have a tough time finding a matching stem cell donor, but for Indigenous Canadians, it could be even tougher. Only 1% of people on the Canadian Stem Cell Registry are Indigenous. Together, we can help change that. Join me in making a difference for Indigenous patients. Sign up for Canadian Blood Services Stem Cell Registry. All you need to do is step up, get swabbed, and you can save a life. Register now at blood.ca.
Good morning, hockey fans. We're excited to be back here on the ice here at the George Preston Recreation Center. This morning, athletes will compete in five exciting hockey skills contests, all in support of Hockey Gives Blood. And let's find out who will rise to the top in the first ever Spartan Skills Challenge. Spartan faithful, it's time to get off your couch and make some noise. It's time to meet the home team, your Trinity Western University Spartans. Number 2, Mackenzie Mayo. Number 4, Kiki Richardson. Number 6, Anika Pirtle. Number 7, Brooklyn Anderson. Number 8, Kate Bumstead. Number 9, Lainey Nichols. Number 10, Jesse Sylvain. Number 11, Riley White. Number 12, Riley Keller. Number 15, Ashley Wolf. Number 16, Laurel Golick.
Hi, Chloe. Hi, Cheyenne.
Number 18, Chloe Reed.
Hi, Cheyenne. Hi, Laurel.
Number 19, Haley Johnson. Number 20, Brooklyn Moore. Number 21, Desi Weens. Number 22, Cheyenne Harder.
Hi, Chloe. Hi, Laurel.
Number 23, Nisha Gurman. Number 25, Ashley Carr. Number 26, Chase Scott. Number 27, Emily Johnson. Number 33, Chantel Weller. Number 35, Jordan Mako. Number 39, Jaden Casting. Number 47, Jade Ridgewell. And number 49, Mackenzie Summonchuk. And the head coach of your Spartans, Sean LaFore. All right, fans, it's now time for the fastest skater competition. It's now time for the fastest skater competition. It's time to get things started. Athletes will compete one at a time in a race against the clock. As they start on one blue line, speed away around the boards to the opposite blue line to see who has the fastest time. The contestants for the fastest skater are Nisha Gurman, Jesse Sylvain, Ashley Carr, Mackenzie Summonchuk, Ashley Wolf, Chloe Reed, Laurel Golick, and Chase Scott. First up will be Nisha Gurman.
So there you have it. That's our 2020-2021 Trinity Western Spartans women's hockey team. There's our lineups. You'll notice that they were physically distant and wearing masks. All the staff here at George Preston Arena have done a great job at making this event possible and making sure that it's COVID safe. So Nisha Gurman, first here in the fastest skater competition. Looking forward to seeing what the first nine skaters here do for Trinity Western. Gurman, the first one up here, will be measuring in miles per hour, as is customary with the NHL, so we're following suit there. We'll have a timer set up. You can see it on your screen. And Gurman will be first up, followed by Sylvain, Carr, Semenchuk, Wolf, Reed, Golnick, Scott, and Brooklyn Anderson, rounding out the skaters here for this first competition. We'll have a total of five for this event. Hardest shot, a shootout, shot accuracy, and agility in support of Hockey Gives Blood. still setting up the rink here as we prepare to get set. And just a reminder, you have a shot at helping save a life. Team up with Hockey Gives Blood and become a regular blood donor. Book now at blood.ca/HGB. And you can also visit GoSpartans.ca.
To follow COVID protocol, make sure spacing is correct.
As we will have a donation link there.
As best we
and you can donate to Hockey Gives Blood and support the Spartans. So just finishing setting up the rink now for this fastest skater competition. German set there at the red line. This is the second skills competition of the year for the Spartans. The basketball teams hosted one a few months ago there at the Langley Event Center, an awesome event there in support of Shoot for the Cure. And Spartans squeaking in one more event this year. So there's German there getting set up. She's at the blue line. And she's off. So we'll be measuring her speed in miles per hour as she rounds the net there. And she clocks in, looks like that top speed there was 22 miles per hour. It holds at 21. I'm not sure whether or not we'll count the 22, and it looks like we will. So 22 miles per hour for Nisha German. She sets the bar there in that first fastest skater competition, and she gets a round of applause from her teammates. And next up here will be Jesse Sylvain. You'll recognize that last name. Her brothers Josh and Joe, both former and current Spartans. As Jesse is now off. Gets up to 18. 22 there. And so that 22 mile per hour mark will tie Nisha German for tops in the competition so far. So a tie atop the leaderboard right now as Jesse Sylvain and Nisha German both have 22 miles per hour on the clock. Next up, we're gonna have Ashley Carr. She makes her way to the blue line. And here we go, number 25, Ashley Carr rounding around the net. Picks up speed, gets up to 23 there, it looked like, for a second. And 23 would be the top in this competition right now. They're holding on 21. So Mackenzie Semenchuk up next here. She's just getting on her helmet. Now she's skating over to the blue line. So number 49, Mackenzie Semenchuk, the winger from Grimsby, Ontario, is off to the races here. Around behind the net there. She got up to 22. So Ashley Wolf, the fifth skater in the competition, coming up here. Ashley Wolf, the former Swift Current Wildcat. Number 15 in white right now. figuring out her place on the ice. Looks like for the time being, Chloe Reed might take place here. So number 18 in white, Chloe Reed up next. And Reed is off to the races here. Picks up some speed, gets up to 21 and 23 for a second there as it holds at 22 miles per hour. So a lot of very close times right now. 22 seems to be the even number across the board. Gurman, the first skater, getting up to 22 miles per hour. Sylvain as well, and Chloe Reed also at 22. Ashley Wolf now taking her turn. As Wolf around behind the net, she picks up speed. And Wolf will make it up to 20 for a moment there. So Ashley Wolf getting up to 20 miles per hour in this fastest skater competition. Still got three skaters to go here. Laurel Golnick, Jay Scott, and Brooklyn Anderson. And looks like Golnick will be the next one up here. Golnick number 16 in blue. And she gets set on the blue line. Now she's off. Golnick's got some speed. She picks it up, gets past 23, 24 for a moment there. As it holds at 21. So Laurel Golnick with a ton of speed there. So 21 miles per hour as it holds there for Laurel Golnick, as Jay Scott, Brooklyn Anderson, it looks like, might be next here. So the center, number 7, Brooklyn Anderson. As Anderson is off. Anderson round behind the net. She's got a lot of speed. Gets up to 22. As it goes back down to 21. So it looks like we do have a tie here. See if there's a tie-breaking procedure in this, or if we do have... So we got Scott remaining. So Jesse Sylvain will go for the tiebreaker here. As she rounds around the net, Sylvain picks up some speed. She's flying now, gets up to 23. So now we got Chloe Reed, also hit 22 today. Reed in the fastest skater competition. Around behind the net, Chloe Reed. Up to 23 for a second there. And as we're in this tie-breaking final. So another tie between Sylvain and Reed, this time at 23. So we'll have another tiebreaker as Sylvain is off to the races once again. Sylvain picking up speed. Gets up to 22 there. And she's got to be getting tired now. There's been a lot of skating. She's already done three laps here. So Chloe Reed now looking to either tie at 22 or win it with 23 or more. Reed around the net. She's trying to pick up some speed. See if she gets up there. And it looked like for a moment there we hit 25 miles per hour. We'll see if that counts. It should. And it's going to be Chloe Reed winning at 25 miles per hour in the fastest skater competition. Very impressive time there for Reed. Had to take three laps to do it. And on her third, she gets 25 miles per hour. And she now has an interview with Tyler Jones. We'll throw it down to Tyler.
Congratulations, Chloe, on winning our fastest skater challenge. You must be exhausted after that. Tell us how you're feeling after your big win.
I'm really tired. I can't breathe.
All right. Well, we'll let you go rest up. Very well done.
Thanks.
Let's have a nice hand for Chloe Reed.
So there we have it, and that's it for the fastest skater competition, and next up we have the hardest shot.
Fans, our next contest is the hardest shot competition. Athletes will each take two back-to-back shots in the first round. The top three will advance with only one final shot each to determine our winner. This is also our fundraiser contest in support of Hockey Gives Blood. The Spartans will donate $1 for a shot that is from 50 to 59 miles an hour.
So there you have it. It's the Hockey Gives Blood competition here. It's the hardest shot.
Spartans
for every shot that hits 50 to 59 miles per hour will get $1 donated to Hockey Gives Blood and $3 for every shot that's 60 miles per hour plus.
Mackenzie Mayo, Jade Ridgewell, Kate Bumstead, Riley Kellner, Desi Weens, Riley White, and Jesse Sylvain.
So Shayana Harden up here first. She'll have two shots for every skater here. We'll see if she can get in that 50 to 59 mile per hour mark. As Harden takes her first shot. Like a hard one. We're waiting for feedback on the shot here. Doesn't look like it recorded it, so she might get a freebie there. So on the ice, we're just trying to make sure that all the shots are registering. So as I mentioned, this is the competition for Hockey Gives Blood. It's the hardest shot one. For every 50 to 59 mile per hour shot, we'll donate $1 and $3 for every shot that makes it 60 miles per hour plus. So Harden here up first, making sure that every shot registers here. It looks like we're just getting it set up now. So Harden, Mayo, Ridgewall, Bumstead, Kellner, Weens, White, and Sylvain in this competition. A reminder that the donation is online. As there's the shot there. See if it registers. Still doesn't register here. Harden now looking to take a third shot, trying to get these shots to register on the clock here. As there's a third shot, makes it up to 40 miles per hour. So a hard shot there from Cheyenne Harden. Makes it all the way up to 40. She'll get a second one here after the first two didn't register. But first up, we'll have Mackenzie Mayo taking her first shot of the day. Looks like the key is just getting it low so it registers. Here's Mayo with a hard shot. Looks like that one slightly high as well, so it didn't register. She'll take a second one here. Hard one there as well. And just behind the net is Jean Laferre, the head coach. And looks like he's recording the speeds as well. So I'm not quite sure what that shot by Mayo hit on the speedometer. Have to check on that. But Ridgewall is up next here. The third shooter in the hardest shot, Jade Ridgewall. Ridgewall fires it and it hits 15. I think it might have been a little bit faster there, as Ridgewall will go for her second. Ridgewall steps in on the shot, takes it, and hits 45. So 45 miles per hour for Jade Ridgewall. Hard shot there on her second. And up next, we'll have Kate Bumstead. 5'8 defenseman from Manitoba. Went to school at St. Mary's Academy, and Bumstead will take her first shot here. Lays into it. Couldn't quite see it register on that one. So she'll take her second up. Here's Bumstead. Wires it. And not too sure on the time there as well. This is the first skills competition for the hockey team. Still working out the kinks. As Kellner now steps in to take her first shot. Number 12 in blue, Riley Kellner, steps in on it, hits the post. And that one couldn't quite register. Kellner for her second shot, takes it. And as well, couldn't see the speed on that one. Kellner will take a third. Pardon me, Weens will take her first shot here. Jean's behind the net there, the head coach of the Spartan women's hockey team. So he's recording these shots here. Just can't quite relay it, but Weens here takes her shot. Looked like a fast one there. As Weens will now take her second. Desi Weens. There's a hard shot right there as Desi Weens took her second. So the seventh shooter in the hardest shot competition, Riley White. That's number 11 in white. As White takes her first. That one clipped off the bar and wide. And so White will take her second. Here's White. And that one hitting 61 miles per hour off the bar and in. So that'll be $3 towards Hockey Gives Blood. Potentially the fastest shot, rather, of the day for the Spartans so far, as it's Riley White hitting 61 miles per hour on the clock. A great shot there from White. As it's Jesse Sylvain here rounding out the hardest shot for the Spartans. Takes her first and it hits 45. And her second, not sure if that one registered, it was a bit high. But she hits 45 on her first. Sounds like the official results will come shortly. If I'd have to guess, looks like Riley White, 61 miles per hour, might take it. As it's Jean who's got the official times there. Running it over to the score table. Reminder that this is the competition for the donations to Hockey Gives Blood. So every shot that went 50 to 59 miles per hour . So it's Mackenzie Mayo winning this competition. And sounded like it was 65 miles per hour. We'll go to Tyler down at ice level with Mackenzie.
So where did you learn your shooting tricks? Is it mom, dad, a former coach?
I'd have to say dad.
All right. Well, very well done out there, and enjoy your prize.
Thank you.
And now, up next, we have our shootout. And now, let's meet the contestants for our shootout. Six athletes will each take three shots. One in each goalie in round one. The top three will advance to the final. Our judges will be giving a score of 10 on each shot. The score is based on creativity, with extra points if the athlete scores. Today's contestants will be Neha Gurman, Brooklyn Anderson, Desi Weens, Kiki Richardson, Ashley Wolf, and Riley Kellner.
So we got the shootout competition here. Three shots each skater. We got
our
a total
shooter will be
of
Neha
six
Gurman.
Skaters. It's Nisha Gurman up first. Each shot will be judged out of a score of 10. And extra points if they score. So number 23 in blue, Nisha Gurman, the first up in the shootout competition. She'll be followed by Anderson, Weens, Richardson, Wolf, and Kellner in this shootout. Nisha Gurman scored quite a few goals in the few preseason games the Spartans had earlier in the year when COVID protocols were a little bit loosened. So we'll hopefully see a lot of creativity in this competition here in the shootout. Just finishing up getting set up. It'll be three goalies, yeah, that's right, in this shootout. They'll rotate through each shot as it's Gurman up first in the shootout. Gurman takes her time, wrists it, and it's saved. That one by number 33, Chantel Weller. So Weller stays in goal. Brooklyn Anderson up next here in the shootout. Walks in on Weller, takes her time, goes to the backhand, but a nice kick save by Weller, using the right pad to keep that one out. And it's Desi Weens, the third shooter in this shootout competition. Weens moves in, takes her time, goes to the backhand, tries to tuck it in, but once again, it's that right pad by Weller keeping it out. So Weller with three saves already in this competition, 3 for 3. It's Kiki Richardson looking to kick off the scoring here, the captain of this Spartans team. Richardson moves in, cuts wide, now moves back to the middle and she tried to chip it over, but Weller gets a piece of it and keeps it out. She's now 4 for 4 in this shootout. Goaltenders doing their job so far here. Wolf up next in the shootout. She moves in, takes her time, goes on the forehand, tries to wait it out, but cut a little bit too wide. And Wolf is 0-for-1. So Weller a perfect 5 for 5, as it's Kellner now moving in, takes a shot, stopped at the chest of Weller. And she's a perfect 5-for-5 in the shootout. So it's Gurman once again looking for her first goal in this competition. Now in the net is McCall. Here's Gurman, goes to the backhand and scores. So first goal of the competition for Nisha Gurman. As you get a replay of it here, a beauty from Gurman. Tucks it in with the backhand. Anderson now up looking for her first goal. Into the middle, Anderson stops up, now tucks it in. A beautiful patience play from Brooklyn Anderson. Gets her first goal of the day as you see the replay there. Great patience, just tucking it in past the left pad. And now Desi Weens looks for her first. Takes a wrist shot, goes 5-hole and scores. And Desi Weens gets her first. Spartans captain Kiki Richardson up next, looking to keep the scoring going here. Richardson in the middle. Takes her time, goes for the wrist shot, but it's stopped at the chest of Jordan McCall. Ashley Wolf, the fifth shooter here. She cuts wide, moves into the middle. Wolf takes her time, but a nice stick save there by McCall. As it's the last shot of the second round here with Riley Kellner, the sixth shooter, in looking for her first. Kellner wires a shot. What a shot there by Kellner. She picked her side and she scored. And Kellner gets her first of the day here. So Weens, Kellner, Anderson, and Gurman with goals in that second round. And Gurman will now look for her second here in her third shot attempt. Gurman moving into the middle, looks for the 5-hole, but that one is kept out by Jadine Kastening. So Kastening with her first save of the day. Perfect 1-for-1 for her, as it's Brooklyn Anderson up next here. Anderson tries to tuck that one in, and that one's saved by Kastening. Desi Weens looking for her second of the day. Weens goes left, now cuts to the middle. Weens now on the backhand, tried to tuck it in, but once again it's Kastening making the save there, getting a piece of it and keeping her perfect record alive. So Kastening with three saves on three shots. Richardson, the captain, looking for her first of the day. Richardson moves to the middle, tried to tuck it in 5-hole, but it's Kastening once again shutting the door, and she moves to 4-for-4. Ashley Wolf, the fifth shooter of this third round. Number 15 in white. Wolf moves in, takes the wrist shot, picks the pocket and scores. And it's Wolf now tying with the other shooters with one goal. Kellner could win it here with her second goal. Moves to the middle, takes the shot, and it goes wide. Not sure if Kastening got a piece of that one. But it stayed out. So with a goal today, it's going to be Nisha Gurman going up in this final round. Gurman at the blue line. We'll see if she goes for something out of the box here. Gurman stepping in the middle. Goes to the backhand, but just couldn't get the shot off. And keeping that one out was number 39, Jadine Kastening. Brooklyn Anderson, the second shooter in this final round. Number 7 in the middle. Anderson stops up. Went for the poke check there, was Kastening, and kept it out with the left pad save. So Anderson doesn't score on her fourth shot. Desi Weens looking for her second goal of this competition. Weens moving in. Goes it on the backhand, but once again kept out by Kastening. So Kastening now has 9 saves in this competition. 9-for-9 in the shootout. Next up, we have Wolf. She cuts wide, and she scores. Wolf with the patience there. I thought she ran out of time, but she played it perfectly and tucked that in behind Kastening for the first goal in this fourth round. Kelmer here takes the shot, kept out by Kastening. Her 10th save out of 11 shots. And it's going to be Ashley Wolf taking the crown here in this shootout competition. So Ashley Wolf with 2 goals on 4 shots, the only skater to get 2 goals, and we'll have an interview here with Tyler Jones down at ice level alongside Ashley Wolf.
Come way over to the interview area, and don't forget your prop.
Congratulations, Ashley. Wow, what a performance. You had some good goaltending to go up against, hey?
Yes.
All right, I'm going to give you a scenario here. The game is on the line. What is your go-to shootout move?
Right in the chest.
Right in the chest.
That's what I do all the time.
Well, apparently that's not the case. So, very well done.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad.
Our next contest will be our shootout accuracy competition. We're moving on to our fourth event, the shootout accuracy competition. 6 athletes will have 30 seconds to take 9 shots each, 3 on each goalie in round number 1. Athletes moving on to the final will only have 1 shot each. We'll be tracking both goals and saves, with goals being indicated as the home score and saves by the goalie designated as the away score. The best score of 9 will be our winner. In case we have a tie, we'll be looking at the fastest overall time for the icebreaker. Athletes competing in our shootout accuracy competition are Jay Scott, Riley White, Cheyenne Harden, Chloe Reed, Kate Bumstead, and Lainey Nichols.
So shootout competition here, 30 seconds, 9 shots each, as Scott scores her first. So she'll go for her second shot here. Scott and Weller in net. Scott moves in, takes another shot and scores. She's 2 for 2. She's got 30 seconds and a total of 9 shots. Scott. That one saved by Weller. She went to shoot left there. So 3 shots in total for Jay Scott and a total of 2 goals for her. And next up is Riley White. Oh, so pardon me. So Scott back up here to take her next 3 shots. 2 for 3 so far for Scott. And a save for Weller. Here's Scott with her first shot. That one saved by the goaltender Jordan McCow. Scott with her second shot here. Moves in, now takes the shot. And once again, it's saved by the goaltender. So Scott 0 for 2 here in this second round. Scott once again taking a shot. It might trickle just wide. So McCow with a perfect 3 for 3 there in the shootout. Scott still with 2 goals. Now in the net is Kastening. You saw her make 10 saves in that shootout before. And now in the shot accuracy competition, we'll see if she can keep that up. Final 3 shots coming up for Jay Scott. Takes her first. That one's stopped by Kastening. Second shot here for Scott. Takes a wrist shot once again, but a blocker save by Kastening. So final shot here for Scott. See what she does. Takes her time, now takes the wrist shot. Looked like she was trying to go 5-hole, or at least to that left pad there by Kastening, but she kept it out. So Kastening and McCow both 3 for 3 in terms of saves, and Scott with 2 goals in that first shot accuracy challenge. Next up, we got Riley White. Takes the shot. That one goes just past the goaltender, Chantel Weller. She's one for one. Now that one saved by Weller. One for two. And a glove save by Weller to finish off those first three shots. So two saves for Weller, one goal for White. And now in net is Jordan McCow. Riley White takes her first shot. That one saved by McCow. Second shot, that one picked the pocket there and scores. And here for the third shot, that one's kept out by the blocker. So now McCow up to five saves, two goals for White. And now Kastening will look to keep her save streak going. That one kept out by the blocker. Kastening now up to five saves. And that one scores, so White scores on her last shot of the day. And she's up to three goals. So currently the leader in this competition, it's a tie between Kastening and McCow with five saves apiece. And it's Riley White with three goals leading the skaters. Here's Cheyenne Harden. Her first shot is saved by Chantel Weller. Second shot goes in. So Harden with her first goal of the day. Harden takes a second shot, or third shot rather, but that one's kept out by Weller. So Weller up to five saves. Harden's got a goal. She's got six shots left. First shot of the second round. That one's just wide of the net. Another save there by Jordan McCow. And third shot here in this second round for Harden. Harden takes the shot, picked her pocket, and scores on that second shot. So Harden up to two goals, and back in net is Kastening. Final three shots of this round for Cheyenne Harden. That one kept out by the blocker. We've seen a lot of shots to the blocker of Kastening. And once again, using the blocker there is Kastening, or second save of this round. And the final shot for Harden, and that one goes in. So Harden up to three goals. That ties Riley White for the lead in goals, and in terms of saves, Jordan McCow and Jadine Kastening with seven saves apiece. Chloe Reed, the next shooter here in this shot accuracy challenge. Reed taking her time. Now she risks a shot on net, and it's kept out by Weller. And that second shot goes in. So Reed with her first goal in this competition, and a second or a third shot is kept out by Weller. So Weller up to seven saves. That ties the other goaltenders. Reed coming up with her fourth shot. That one saved. And the second shot there is saved. See her third in this second round. That one also saved. So Jordan McCow now up to 10 saves in this competition. That leads all goaltenders. Kastening looking to keep the saves alive here. First shot by Reed, kept out by the blocker. Second shot, once again kept out. That was the right pad there by Kastening. And on the final shot, that one goes just wide. Not sure if Kastening got a piece of it, but she's up to 10 saves as well. Number eight, Kate Bumstead now. Takes her first shot on Weller. Not sure if she was ready for that one, but that's a goal for Bumstead. Second shot goes wide. So two saves for Weller there, and one goal for Kate Bumstead. Bumstead in the second round, that one just goes wide. Second shot goes in. And the third one wide as well. So 12 saves now for Jordan McCow. As Kastening now comes in. Bumstead, first shot, and it just tucks in past the bar and in. And the second and third shots are saved. So Bumstead with a goal. That's three now for her in this competition. That ties Cheyenne Hardin and Riley White for the lead. And both Kastening and Jordan McCow have 12 saves to lead the goaltenders. Chantel Weller not far behind with nine, as it's now number nine, Lainey Nichols. First shot saved by Weller. Second shot also wide. And the third one, Weller gets a piece of it. So three for three there for Weller. Perfect three for three for her in this round, as Nichols looking for her first goal. That one saved by the glove. Once again saved by the glove. And just off the post there and out. So three for three for Jordan McCow. 15 saves in this competition. Kastening back in the crease. Nichols looking for her first goal. That one just goes wide, kept out by the blocker. Second shot just nicked off the post once again by Nichols. And her third shot goes into the chest of Kastening. So Kastening also a perfect three for three. She's up to 15 saves on the day. So tie-breaking round now. Riley White, sounds like it's going to be one shot each. White has that shot saved. And that one goes off the bar and out. So that shot by Cheyenne Hardin is kept out. And this final shot gets saved in the chest. So Bumstead has her shot saved, and we're back for another tie-breaking round here as White steps up. Takes her time, takes the shot, and it's saved by number 39, Jadine Kastening. Hardin has her shot go wide, and Bumstead will look to win it here. Kate Bumstead looking to score, and it just goes off the stick and out, so Kastening keeping her save streak alive here. And once again, we'll have another tie-breaking round. White takes her shot, kept out by the stick of Kastening. Hardin moving in to take her shot, and she scores. So Bumstead will look to tie Hardin. If she scores here, she will. And Bumstead has that saved. And so Cheyenne Hardin will win this competition. She scores four goals in it. That leads all skaters. And she'll join Tyler Jones down there at ice level in a moment. And we'll bring it down to Tyler to interview the winner of this competition, Cheyenne Hardin.
Congratulations, Cheyenne. You have won the accuracy competition here today. What's going through your head after that big win?
I'm just thinking about thanking Sarah Potomac after for all the challenges after practice. Thanks, Sarah. That's about it.
Awesome. It must feel so good to be out here today. Tell us what it's been like.
It's really nice to get on the ice and different rank. It's really nice. I don't know.
All right, well, thank you very much, and a job well done.
Thank you.
Congratulations. Next up will be our agility contest. Moving into the final event of the day, the agility contest. We have two agility courses set up on the ice. Athletes will compete two at a time. Athletes will start on the far goal line, go through the course, take a shot on net, and return to the other end of the ice to top off at the face-off circles. The top four will advance on the semifinal, and then the winners of the semifinal go head-to-head in the final for all the bragging rights. Let's meet our competitors in the agility competition. Lainey Nichols, Chloe Reed, Laurel Golnick, Mackenzie Mayo, Ashley Carr, Jade Ridgewell, Mackenzie Semenchuk, and Riley Kellner.
So here we are with the agility competition. A total of eight skaters in this one. Top four advance to the semifinals before we have a final. So agility course, they take a shot on net and then they return to the other side. Lainey Nichols, Chloe Reed, Lauren Golnick, Mackenzie Mayo, Ashley Carr, Jade Ridgewall, Mackenzie Semenchuk, and Riley Kellner in this one. And I believe it'll be Nichols and Reed to start it off here. Assistant coach Sarah Potomac there showing the skaters what to do in this agility course. Somewhat straightforward approach here. A reminder that we do have the Hockey Gives Blood donation link on gospartans.ca, so make sure to check that out after this competition. But here we are on the agility contest. It's Chloe Reed and Lainey Nichols here. Nichols slightly ahead here. She moves in, and it looks like it'll be Nichols here in this first one taking this first heat. So Lainey Nichols winning that first one over Chloe Reed. As next up, we'll have Golnick versus Mayo. Laurel Golnick versus Mackenzie Mayo. Mayo obviously winning that hardest shot competition earlier with a 68 mile per hour shot. And here we are, both skaters with a lot of speed here. We'll come down to the wire, but it was Mackenzie Mayo, number two in white, winning that one. So Mayo takes the second heat over Golnick. And so far in the semifinal, we have Nichols and Mayo. Next up, we have Ashley Carr and Jade Ridgewall. And they're off to the races here. Looks like a tie out of that one. Just losing the puck there was Ashley Carr, and so Ridgewall will take this one. Unfortunate bobble of the puck there by Carr. So Ridgewall takes that heat. And the final competition of this first round here in this agility course is Mackenzie Semenchuk versus Riley Kellner. Here they are here. Both have quite a bit of speed as they round this first corner. And it's going to come down to the wire here. It looks like Kellner taking that one. So semifinal round now here. Nichols and Mayo. Mayo with a ton of speed here. And she'll take that semifinal over Nichols. So Mackenzie Mayo, she'll be in the final here in this agility course. She's already got a competition win in that hardest shot. As we have Scott versus Ridgewall, and it looks like Ridgewall takes this one. So it'll be Ridgewall versus Mayo in the final in this agility course. So Ridgewell versus Mayo. And both Mayo and Ridgewell are off here. Both around the hockey stick. It's going to be close. Looks like Ridgewell just holding possession of the puck there around that final turn. And she'll take it. So Jade Ridgewell wins this final competition of the day. It's the agility course. Ridgewell winning all three of her heats, the first round, the semifinal, and the final. And she'll join Tyler Jones down at ice level for an interview. Take it away, Tyler.
You must be very tired right now.
Yeah, I am definitely very tired.
All right, well, we'll keep this nice and short for you, but tell us what the best part of this year has been for you.
I think just getting to know the team in general, like coming in knowing barely anybody, and now it's just awesome team year.
Glad to hear that, and congratulations.
Thank
very
you.
Well done.
Thank you, Tyler, and we'll go to the announcer for the senior athlete appreciation time.
That ends the contest portion of the Spartan Skills Challenge in support of Hockey Gives Blood. Well, please don't sign off just yet. Thanks to all of you back home who donated today at GoSpartans.ca, where we've posted the donation link. If you haven't donated yet, remember that everyone has a shot at helping to save a life. Team up with Hockey Gives Blood and make a financial donation to help strengthen our national blood system. Donate now at giveblood.ca/HGB. Spartan fans, each year at the end of the season, we recognize our graduating senior athletes. We'd like to take some time to do that this afternoon. Remember, everyone has a shot at helping save a life. Team up with Hockey Gives Blood and make a financial donation to help strengthen our national blood system. Donate now at giveblood.ca/HGB.
There was no doubt in my mind when I first arrived here that Kiki was going to be somebody that I wanted to be involved in a leadership capacity. Right from the time that we started our relationship as a player and coach, we just clicked. It was a fantastic beginning to what has been, I think, in 2 years, a very, very close opportunity to grow together. And she has been lights out in terms of what she's brought. She is truly, if I were to say who exemplifies a complete champion, it's Kiki Richardson. She extremely, extremely strong in terms of all the attributes. She led us in the gym. She led us in the classroom. She led us in terms of faith and bringing people along. Not the most vocal and I would say a strong presence, a leader by example. Day in, day out. And this has been a challenging year for all of us. And she came back deliberately to come and experience U Sport. There was light at the end of the tunnel that we were going to be able to have games in the second half, and that didn't materialize. It never fazed her enthusiasm. It didn't faze her want and desire to still lead, to do extra time in and time out, to take what are a lot of first-year players under her wing and show them the ropes in terms of being here at Trinity. She set the standard as a leader in our program, and I can't say thank you enough to her for all of her efforts, whether it was, I think she did absolutely every recruit visit last year. They all did a face-to-face with her on campus, and she took the process and ran with it. And I'm going to miss her. And I think her teammates as well will miss her too as she moves on. Obviously, she'll always be a Spartan, and I would love the opportunity to see her come back and visit with us. But yeah, she definitely, for me, is a Spartan true through and through, and a complete champion.
Spartan faithful, please join me in congratulating Kiki Richardson. We also want to take a moment to thank the parents, family, and close friends of Kiki who have encouraged her throughout her hockey career. Thank you for spending many hours in many different areas over the years, supporting, encouraging, and building into her life to help Kiki become a complete champion in all areas of her life. We wish you could be there with us in person today, but we appreciate your support from wherever you're watching today. Ladies and gentlemen, your 2020-21 Spartan Women's Hockey graduating senior athlete, Kiki Richardson.
So a very special moment there, congratulating their team captain, Kiki Richardson of the Spartans. She served as the captain this year along with last year, and a very special moment for her as she gets a moment to be congratulated. And hockey fans, that wraps up the Spartan Skills Challenge this afternoon for the women. Your Spartans raised a ton of money for Hockey Gives Blood, but you can still add to that total by visiting gospartans.ca and clicking on our Hockey Gives Blood donation link. And congratulations again to the winners of the skills contest today. Fastest skater winner, Chloe Reed, clocking in at 25 miles per hour. The hardest shot winner, Mackenzie Mayo, at 68 miles per hour. A hard shot there. Our shootout winner, Ashley Wolf, with two goals in the shootout. Shootout accuracy winner, Cheyenne Harden, with four goals. And the agility winner, Jade Ridgewell. And fans, be sure to tune in again at 2:30 p.m. for the Men's Skills Challenge. You won't want to miss out on more Spartans exciting sports action. Keep up to date with all things Spartans by following us on the TWU Spartans app or by visiting gospartans.ca. Thank you for joining us again this afternoon. We can't wait to see you in the stands again, but until that time, stay safe, and thank you for supporting your Trinity Western Spartans.